Romney. Please welcome State Senator Eric Mason. Eric.
Thank you, everyone. What a great day for Republicans, eh? This is a really great day for us. My name is Eric Mason. I know I just introduced myself, but I'll do it again. I represent Senate District 17, which covers everything around the Wisconsin, basically, including the Moxie Capital of the World, Lily Paul Maine. Today we have the opportunity and the responsibility of making sure that Barack Obama is a one-term president. But this is a very serious time in America, and we have the chance today to be a major player on the national team. Our next guest and I are voting for Mitt Romney, and we're here to ask you to join us. We believe he's the most prepared for the difficult task at hand. We all know that jobs and the economy are the most important issues on the minds of every American right now, and I know that that's especially true of me. He's the only candidate with a real experience of creating real jobs in the real economy. Senator Kelly Ayotte of New Hampshire is a New England native. In 2004, she was appointed AG by a Republican governor and appointed two times after that by a Democrat. She fought for new laws against sexual predators, particularly children. She held public officials responsible for their actions. And she, with her policies, helped make New Hampshire one of the safest places in the entire nation. As a member of the Criminal Justice Public Safety Committee that deals with the criminal code every day, and a member of the Government Oversight Committee that put Paul Violet in jail, Ayotte is a real model for justice in this country. She ran for office for the first time in 2010 and won with 60% of the vote in Hampshire. And Kelly, most recently, has been leading the charge to repeal Obamacare in the U.S. Senate. Days ago, she was on Fox News calling the mandate to provide abortion by Catholic charities and all such as an affront to religious liberty. So I'm very proud, it's my honor and privilege to introduce the Senator from New Hampshire, the Honorable Kelly Ayotte.
What President Obama was doing and what the Democrats were doing. doing. We saw it with Obamacare. We saw it with more spending, more debt, bigger government, taking us to a place where we did not want to be. The fundamental transformation of America to the America that is not what we love. And that's what got me off my couch. My husband is a veteran, served in the Iraq War, served as an A-10 pilot, flew combat missions there. So we're a military family. And when my husband came home from the war, he started a small business. We have a landscaping and snow plowing business. And I spent a lot, I know how hard it is to start your own business. I'm sure we have some small business owners here today. Spent a lot of time shoveling snow. And yes, something I know you'll appreciate in Maine, I can drive a truck with a snow plow on it. Well, I can tell you the other thing that's really important to me and what really motivates me every single day are our two children. We are blessed, Joe and I, have a 4-year-old and a 7-year-old, Catherine and Jacob. And that's really what got me into my own race and what I'm so worried about in the U.S. Senate every single day. Here's who I am. I'm a conservative. I'm the only pro-life woman in the United States Senate.
Aggressively to
to roll back regulations on small businesses like my husband, including Obamacare. She's been leading the effort on the balanced budget amendment in the U.S. Senate, and I can tell you one thing. We know she can win, and we can't lose any Republican seats, okay?
That's right!
By the way, we can't just lose any Republican seats. We need four more. Four more so we can take majority in the U.S. Senate if our leader agrees. Make no mistake, winning matters. And what you do today is very, very important. Your vote has great consequence when it comes to this election. Not only your vote individually, but your votes collectively in terms of what will happen in November. Well, let me tell you about my worst nightmare. Here is my worst nightmare. Waking up on November 3rd and finding out that Barack Obama has a second term. That's my worst nightmare. That's what keeps me up at night, because four more years of the Obama agenda, and we are not going to be able to dig ourselves out of the hole we are in with $15 trillion of debt. Four more years of the Obama agenda, we will not be able to repeal Obamacare. We will have socialized medicine. Four more years of the Obama agenda, we are going to continue to have a climate where it's difficult for small businesses, where it's difficult for the private sector in this country, and to put people to work. Four more years of the Obama agenda, he's re-elected, ladies and gentlemen. More of everything that we all hate. More spending, more debt, more government agencies run amok, like the National Labor Relations Board. Y'all followed that one? Yeah. More regulations that infringe on our constitutional rights, like the recent effort that infringes on our rights to conscience and religious freedom. More infringement on our Constitution, and moving us to be who we are not. He is moving us to be a European social welfare state, and if we give him four more years, we are in deep trouble, ladies and gentlemen.
That's right.
You're right.
So I'm here today. I look very carefully at this field. As you know, in New Hampshire, we're blessed to have the first in the nation primary. So we had a few candidates coming around New Hampshire, presidential candidates. And I'm here today supporting Mitt Romney. Because I know if Mitt Romney is our nominee, I have that feeling in my heart that if Mitt Romney is our nominee, that I won't wake up on November 3rd with the worst hangover ever with four more years of Barack Obama. You may not agree with me. Greatest appeal to independent voters. We are here today because we are strong Republicans. We believe in those conservative principles, and that is what we need to take to the White House. We get those independent voters also, or we will not win this election. Just look at my own state. We have 40% independent voters in New Hampshire. We are one of the swing states in this country that are going to decide this election. And I can tell you, if Mitt Romney's our nominee, we will win New Hampshire, we will win independent voters, and we will win this election.